When it comes to starting your engine on a freshly installed aftermarket standalone ECU with no base map for the very first time, this can be daunting. Particularly, I know a lot of novice tuners tend to think that if we don't have exactly the right fuel and ignition numbers in the tables when we go to crank our engine for the first time, we can risk expensive damage to the engine. The reality is that nothing could be further from the truth. In this free lesson, you'll see just how easy it is to get our engine up and running for the very first time and how we can quickly dial in our fuel and ignition numbers with no risk to damaging the engine. Now we're at a point where we can finally start the engine for the first time, and particularly to novice tuners this can seem quite daunting. As I've mentioned in the main body of the course, there's a belief that we need to have the numbers for our fuel and our ignition timing absolutely perfect before the engine can ever be started, or we risk doing damage. And it's really not the case, as we're going to see very shortly. We can quickly dial in our volumetric efficiency to get the air fuel ratio where we need it to be by making very fast and coarse adjustments to the VE table. Now, during this initial startup, we don't want to be looking for exact changes to our VE. We're just going to be making coarse changes to quickly get the fueling close to our target. At the same time, while we're doing this, we're going to be looking at the feedback from our two lambda sensors here. So these are fitted in the exhaust system, and they're wideband lambda sensors that are being fed directly into the Infinity ECU so that we can see what the air fuel ratio is doing. At the same time, we have our lambda target, so this is simply coming from our lambda target table, so we can instantly see if we're too rich or too lean when we get the engine running. Now, because we have no map for the engine at this stage, it's likely that the engine's not going to perhaps idle well by itself. So we may be prepared, we need to be prepared to keep the engine running initially with the throttle while we're getting the air fuel ratio on target. When we're dealing with an ECU such as the Infinity, where the ECU is using a VE-based fuel model, because we're talking about actual engine volumetric efficiency, generally the task of getting the VE table dialed in coarsely is a little bit simpler than if we were tuning an injector pulse width-based ECU fuel model. Okay, so let's get our engine up and running now, and what we're going to do is first of all highlight all of the cells in the area of the table that we're expecting to be running in. So in this case, 0 out to 1500 RPM and all the way from 0 kPa to 100 kPa. So this means that I'm not going to be making changes to an individual cell. I'm going to be able to make changes to multiple cells that the engine's operating in. This means I don't need to chase the particular cell the ECU is accessing while I'm making changes. If we right click, we can see the options that are available for making these changes. We can add or subtract 1% to the numbers by using the plus and minus keys. Now, again, because we're making coarse changes, or likely to be making coarse changes, probably not going to be interested in making 1% changes, so we can add and subtract 10% by using the control plus and control minus keys. Of course, we can do this directly from this drop down menu here by right clicking, but that's not generally how we're going to be making these changes. So again, I'll just highlight those cells and we can crank the engine and get it running. Okay, so straight away the engine fires up, and I'm using a small amount of throttle to maintain 1000 RPM idle, and we can see what our lambda's doing here. You can see that we're sitting at around about 0.95 to 0.98. There's a slight discrepancy bank to bank. So far you can see I haven't even made a single change to the VE table, and we've already got our engine up and idling and operating correctly. So it's been incredibly easy. As the engine settles a little bit, you can see our lambda is moving a little bit lean. So let's just add a little bit to our VE table, and we're now operating at 0.92, 0.93 lambda. While we're doing this, you can see we've got our coolant temperature and our air temperature being displayed. We're watching those parameters as the engine warms up. We'd also be taking this opportunity during an initial start to be inspecting the engine in the engine bay, particularly if it's a freshly built engine or an unknown engine. We want to make sure that the engine isn't leaking fluids. We want to make sure that the engine isn't making any unusual mechanical sounds that would be an indicator that something's wrong. But that's as easy as it is to get our engine up and running for the very first time. You'll notice at this point, I haven't even talked about the ignition timing table. Remember, we initially started by setting the entire table to 15 degrees. Now that means I know that the ignition timing in the idle areas and the cranking areas that we've just used, just been accessing, is going to be close enough to get the engine running relatively well. Because we've gone through the procedure of setting our base timing, we know that the timing will match what we have in the ECU, so we don't even need to worry about our ignition timing while we're going through this initial startup. Right, now that we've got our engine running for the very first time, we can move on to the next step. That was just one module taken from our complete practical standalone ECU tuning course. This course is designed to teach you how to tune any aftermarket standalone engine management system from start to finish. We know that, particularly for novice tuners, it can be daunting when faced with the task of tuning a freshly installed ECU with absolutely no base map or start file. In this course, we present you the HPA 10-step process, and by breaking the entire tuning process down into 10 bite-sized steps, each of those individual steps is relatively quick and easy to complete. By following that process from start to finish, in no time, you've got a completely tuned engine that's offering optimal power, optimal torque, and most importantly, ensuring great engine reliability. By following this 10-step process through, you're also going to ensure that you don't overlook any critical steps that could waste time and money or even result in damage to your engine. This course is applicable to any aftermarket standalone engine management system and any combination of engine. To find out more about this course, click the link in the description.